is the Writer's Almanac for Thursday. It's the 11th of March, 2021. 1818, on this day, the novel Frankenstein or the Modern Prometheus was published by 21-year-old Mary Shelley. The story of the scientist Victor Frankenstein and the creature that he forged from the spare parts of corpses. A book now considered a modern classic and considered the very first science fiction novel. It's the anniversary of the great blizzard of 1888. 55 inches of snow hit the northeast coast of the United States. New York was especially hard hit. All the gas lines, water lines, phone lines, the train lines, all of them above ground were frozen, in some cases burst, and it was then that New York began to go underground. Snow came up to the second story of buildings. It was on this day, 1969, Levi Strauss began selling bell-bottomed jeans. They had been popular among sailors, and then they became popular among hippies. It's the birthday of Douglas Adams, born in Cambridge, England, 1952, author of The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, in which a man named Arthur is saved from the destruction of Earth by an alien travel journalist who picks him up in a spaceship, and he goes off to meet a robot who is depressed, the two-headed galactic president, and the only other human survivor in the universe, a woman whom Arthur once met at a party. It's the birthday of Rupert Murdoch, born outside Melbourne, Australia, 1931, who at the age of 21 inherited two of his father's papers in Adelaide, the News and the Sunday Mail, and he made them profitable by turning them into tabloids full of sex and scandal and gossip. He bought up more newspapers in Sydney and Melbourne and then moved to London. Bought the Sun newspaper, where he began the so-called Page 3 feature, pictures of topless women on the third page of the newspaper. Came to this country, bought the New York Post, the Village Voice, National Geographic TV Guide, bought the Fox Television Network, and Fox News in 1996. And it's the birthday of the children's author and illustrator Ezra Jack Keats, born Jacob Ezra Katz in Brooklyn, 1916, who illustrated more than 80 children's books. Ezra Jack Keats, who said, "I love city life. All the beauty that other people see in country life, I find taking walks and seeing the multitudes of people." Here's a poem for today by Dennis O'Driscoll, The Clock. With only one story to tell, the clock strikes a monotonous note, irrespective of how musical the bell, how gilded the chimes, its timely conclusions report through. Time literally on hands. It informs you to your face exactly where you stand in relation to your aspirations, stacks up the odds against your long-term prospects, leaves your hopes and expectations checked. Keeping track of time to the last second, it gives the lie to all small talk about your reputedly youthful looks, sees through the subterfuge of dyed hair, exposes the stark truth beneath the massaged evidence of smooth skin. A poem by Dennis O'Driscoll, The Clock, from Reality Check, published by Copper Canyon Press, and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac, funded by donations from listeners like you. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.